In this webcast, we're going to take a look at one step of the Shikimate pathway. We'll focus in on this elimination reaction catalyzed by dehydroquinate dehydratase. You're not really going to learn anything new in this webcast, but what this allows us to do is to apply some of the principles that you've been hearing about in the previous webcast to one particular step of this reaction mechanism. So you know that when we talked about elimination reactions, we were interested in knowing what the stereochemistry of that elimination was. Does it proceed by syn or anti? And that allows us to potentially rule out some mechanisms by which this reaction may go. And so that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to look first at the stereochemistry, and then we'll take a look at the mechanism. So of the two hydrogens that could possibly be lost, the pro-S or the pro-R hydrogen across this carbon-carbon single bond to make this carbon-carbon double bond, deuterium studies show experimentally that it's the pro-R hydrogen that's removed. The hydrogen S remains behind. That tells us right away that what we're dealing with is a syn elimination. This is pretty easy to pick up in these ring compounds. These ring compounds, we see the transformation of that ring system, which divides basically the plane of what will become the carbon-carbon double bond. And so we can see that HR, the proton that is removed, and water both have stereochemistry that is down below that plane. And so we can imagine that the elimination is on the same side. The groups that leave are on the same side of the plane of what becomes the double bond. That would be the syn elimination. But let me take you through the process in full detail. Anytime we're dealing with a ring compound, you ought to be able to transform it from these planar structures into the two chair structures. Remember that anytime we draw a six-membered ring, we have to think about both conformations that are available. And what we're going to learn in this example, when we work through both ring flipped forms, that both of them show it's a syn elimination process. So in the one ring flip form, the hydroxyl group would be drawn in the axial conformation, and then here it is in the equatorial conformation. The pro-R hydrogen, the one that's removed, here it's in the equatorial, and in the ring flip form it's in the axial. In both cases, when we look down the carbon-carbon bond, which will become the carbon-carbon double bond, and draw that Newman projection, so the plane of what will become the double bond is drawn there, and you can see that HR and OH are on the same side. That's the syn elimination pathway. Similarly, in this other ring flip form, we get the exact same answer as we must, but we need to go through that process and convince ourselves of that. Looking down the carbon-carbon bond that becomes the carbon-carbon double bond, HR and OH are on the same side of that, what will become the plane of that double bond. Again, we conclude it's a syn elimination. Now, with ring compounds, because there isn't this conformational flexibility, it's really quite easy to pick this up, and it's a little bit more challenging in these open chain conformations where you have to find the right conformation that proceeds by the elimination. So since it's a syn elimination, we can conclude that the mechanism is not E2, and we can guess that the mechanism might be an E1CB mechanism. And that's basically what goes on. But in dehydroquinate dehydratase, there is a lysine present in the active site, and we can imagine that the combination now of a carbonyl and a lysine is what we expect to produce by covalent catalysis or nucleophilic catalysis, the iminium ion intermediate. And indeed, that's how this reaction proceeds. It's an E1CB that involves the iminium ion formation. So the pattern that you should get used to when you see in the active site a lysine with a carbonyl substrate is to think about the iminium ion formation. Remember that that's going to enhance the acidity of any carbon that is alpha to the carbon-nitrogen double bond. So that alpha position to the iminium ion has enhanced acidity. HR then can be removed by some side chain, which at this point it's not disclosed what it is, but there's a basic side chain that then becomes protonated in the enzyme active site. And we have the enamine structure drawn here. So the carbon-nitrogen single bond connected to a carbon-carbon double bond, and the what was the base has now been protonated. That's useful because the bond that is going to be broken, we're going to lose the elements of water, and we can do that with general acid catalyzed process using the hydrogen, using the proton from the conjugate acid of the base that we used in the step preceding. So that's how the electron flow looks for that loss of water. And overall, this two-step process of deprotonation followed by beta elimination, this second step is really best labeled as a beta elimination. So E1CB is the two-step process, the second step of these being the beta elimination, which goes on here to cause the loss of water, and the aminium ion will be regenerated. Hydrolysis of that aminium ion, that is, we're going to just add water into that, and it follows similar to what we saw with the aldolase enzyme, produces the final product, which is the dehydroshikimate product that's shown here. Let's take a look at one more thing. This, if you notice, I've drawn this structure in kind of a funny way. Here is the normal chair form, but I've drawn this in a twist boat form, and it turns out there's a reason that people think that the enzyme forces the substrate to occupy this twist boat conformation, because it, as you'll see on the next slide, changes the orientation of this hydrogen bound to carbon in the alpha position to be almost perpendicular to the plane of that double bond. By inducing that conformation in the substrate, the relationship between the carbon-hydrogen bond and the pi system is to place those groups such that there can be overlap, orbital overlap, between the CH sigma bond and the pi star system. So here's pi star of the aminium group, and with that conformation, there's really excellent overlap between the sigma orbital and the pi star orbital, which also enhances the acidity. So somehow, and we saw this with strain in when we talked about one of the thermolysin peptidase enzyme, basically strain here is used again, in this case to enhance orbital overlap, sigma to pi star orbital overlap, making that alpha hydrogen even more acidic.